tuning in to your inner world if you haven't already. Noticing thoughts, sensations, perhaps noticing your breath. Noticing the surface or surfaces below you. Letting that information come in. Also allowing information to come up from the body. Placing one hand on your heart, one hand on your belly. Notice breath moving underneath your palms. For a thought of the day. This is coming from my Ashtanga yoga teacher. He would always say, practice patience and surrender. As we move through our practice today, let's focus mostly on the spine, the core, the center of the body. In a practice that is opening up the heart, practicing patience and surrender with ourselves. Staying curious and compassionate for ourselves and others. And knowing that through that patience, through that surrender, and through the repetition of our practice, new information will come up and out. Wherever you are, start to bring some more movement into your body. Wiggling around, shifting around, stretching out. And then whatever shape you are in, bring your awareness to your spine. And see if you can add in, if you're lying down, maybe it's curling into a ball, adding in some more information that really brings some sensitivity to the spine. So that could be curling up in a ball, maybe rolling a little bit. If you're in a position where hands can find the spine, maybe you start to poke around a little bit. Knowing that our spine is really this midline of the body. And it's quite deep within the body. And if you haven't placed hands on the spine, starting to do so. Whether that's from lying down or an upright position. You can shake your head yes and no. Knowing that the top two vertebra in our spine that allow us to agree or disagree. Haven't made it to your side or seated yet, starting to adjust. So with our vertebrae, you have like this little spiky thing that hangs off the back of it. Imagine that that's like a little light switch and you're gently going to press down on it. Each vertebra all the way down your spine. So gently pressing down, like you're turning a light switch off, all the way down your spine. And it's a gentle pressure. Slowly moving down your back. A little press down. Each of the little bony parts of your spine. This time, again, going down the spine, bringing fingertips to either side of the spine, kind of these little groovy parts on either side of the spine. You can do this with one hand or with both. Just start to create little circles in there. Again, inching down the entire spine. Notice any sensations that come up. And being patient with yourself if sensations aren't coming up for you. You've gone all the way down your spine. Begin to warm up the entire body with really focusing on the spine. So any spinal movement that you want, Maybe it's some twists, maybe it's some tilts, rounding or arcing. You can segment this as well, maybe just the cervical spine, that top third, maybe just the thoracic spine or upper back, maybe just the lumbar spine or low back. Eventually, let the spinal movement take you into a child's pose. In your child's pose, find some spinal movement here as well. See if you can keep the ribs close to the thighs. So it's going to limit the lower spine and ask the thoracic and cervical spine to do a bit more. From your child's pose, starting to take your hands over to the right side, lengthen out the left side body. And maybe the right hand goes under your right shoulder and you can look over your right shoulder. Coming back through center and doing the same thing on the other side. As we continue to move through this, notice where the eyes go. Notice where your focus goes. The spine follows your eyes, follows your focus. And we'll play with that a little bit today. You can take the left hand under your left shoulder again as another option. Back through center and then up to a tabletop position. Palms are underneath the shoulders, knees are underneath your hips. Taking a cat-cow here and any other spinal movement that you would like. Notice where your eyes go. If you'd like, you can start to play with the position of the eyes versus the position of the spine. So if you find that as you go into a cat-cow, that the eyes tend to follow up and down, maybe the next cat-cow, you look to the right with keeping your nose pointing forward. And then you could also shift it and look to the left, keeping the nose pointing forward. So it's the position of the eyes that are changing. And then let this go into any other movement that you want or need right now. You can take some shoulder rolls. Maybe some twists. Circle out your wrists, wiggle your ankles. And then eventually making your way to a downward facing dog. In down dog, once again, any wiggles that you want or need, and pedal out your feet, You can continue to explore spinal movement. You can continue to explore the position of your eyes in relationship to your spine. Slowly starting to make your way to a forward fold. Feet meet your hands. You can hold on to your elbows. You can sway any movement that you want or need here. Starting to make your way to like a baby chair pose. So you've got a little bit of a bend in the ankles, knees, and hips. Palms can be on your thighs. And take again your cat-cow and any other spinal movement that you want. As you do this, again, you can notice your eyes. Notice where your focus goes. Also play with how can you condense the spine and how can you really expand and lengthen. So in our developmental movement patterns, as we are learning to crawl, as we are learning to walk, with every movement we think about expanding, we think about taking up more space. So how can you add that in, create a little extra space in your spine with each movement? When you're ready, coming up to stand, lift the toes off the ground, feel a strong connection from the bottom of your feet through the ground, and then place your toes back down. So standing at the front of your mat, we're going to take a variation of Sun Sal A. So inhale, arms come up overhead. And as you exhale, let the head make a figure eight. So your swan dive is a really indirect movement all the way down. All right, roll yourself up, let your focus go to your belly, and take that again. All right, arms up overhead, and then let your head and your eyes take a really indirect path, figure eight, all the way down to your forward fold. From your forward fold, let your eyes initiate looking up and your head follows, your spine follows, lengthening through the crown of your head. And then eyes look down first and the rest of your spine follows. Step yourself back into a plank. Staying here, let your eyes and your head wander. Look around. Pull yourself down to the ground, all the way to your belly. Palms can be underneath your shoulders. Top of the head reaches forward, lengthen the spine as you come up to a cobra. and then lower back down. Hands hover off the ground. Top of the head reaches forward and up, lengthening, lifting, and lower. Take the arms out in front of you, fingertips rest on the ground. Top of the head reaches forward and up as you come up off the ground, and then lower back down. Taking any of those three hand and arm positions, this time when you lift up to your cobra, let the eyes circle while the head stays in the same position. Eyes circle one direction and then your eyes circle the other direction. Lowering back down, let your forehead rest. Knees can bend and let the legs sway, releasing out the low back. Let's take another variation and a progression here. So this time we're gonna go for a little swim. So fingertips reach forward, then they swim back behind you as you lift the upper body off the ground and then back down. Fingertips reach forward. This time clasp your hands behind your back as you lift up and lower down. Taking one of these again, you're going to pause at the top and let the eyes circle around. Notice your breath. Eyes circle one direction and then they circle the other direction. Lowering back down, press yourself back to your downward facing dog. In down dog, take any movement that you want or need here. And then slowly, feet walk themselves forward into your forward fold. Let the eyes initiate here as you lift forward into your half lift. Eyes initiate on the way back down, hinging at your hips. Repeat that figure eight with the eyes and your head to come all the way back up, reversing your swan dive. Arms rise up overhead, and then your arms can come down by your sides. Take a quick inventory of your body. Notice what changed. Notice any shifts. Taking a variation of Sun Salutation B. Bending the knees, sink into your chair pose. Arms can come out to the side, like an airplane. You can keep your arms here or let your hands clasp behind your back. We'll take that same really indirect figure eight, leading with the top of your head as you make your way to a forward fold. If your arms are out to the side, they can continue to stay out to the side. If your hands are clasped, they can reach up towards the ceiling. Once fully in your forward fold, if your hands are clasped behind you, release them to those airplane arms, and then all fingertips come down to the ground. Let your eyes lead you as you lift and lengthen the spine, and then hinge back down. Stepping back to your plank, let your nose continue to point towards the ground and let your eyes slowly move side to side. So our eyes are connected to our nervous system, to the vagus nerve. And when we move them slowly, we're activating a little bit of that parasympathetic rest and digest energy. Slowly lower all the way down to the ground. This time, let's take a locust pose. So fingertips are reaching back behind you. Top of the head is still reaching forward. Reaching forward and up. Lengthen your spine. Chest lifts. Legs lift off the ground as well. Kind of like a penguin sliding on its belly. And then lower back down. Take a moment, stacking your hands. Forehead can rest on them. Bend the knees. Sway a little bit side to side. Releasing out the low back. Palms can come underneath your shoulders. Press yourself on up to your upward facing dog. Let the eyes lift and maybe your spine follows. As you exhale, make your way to downward facing dog. Step your right foot forward. And come on up to Virabhadrasana, warrior pose. Taking the hands behind you, you can hold on to your elbows or you can clasp your hands. Think about the hinge at your hips. Forward we go into a humble warrior. So the right hip's working towards the right thigh. Chest is falling on the inside of your right leg. Press your right heel into the ground. Feel the connection from the heel up to your sits bones and rise back up. Releasing the arms. Option to hold on to your shoulders, lazy hug, or take eagle arms here. Letting the right elbow be underneath the left. Backs of your hands can find each other, or maybe it's your palms. Same hinge at the hips, devoted warrior. Forward we go. Feeling a strong connection with the earth under the right foot. Notice where your focus goes. And then rise back up. Feel the support in the glutes to achieve this. Pelvis, tailbone drop down. Release the arms, reaching up. And then hands come down to the ground, stepping back to your plank. Let your head circle around nice and slow. Notice where the eyes go to follow. Then slowly lower yourself all the way down to the ground, resting on your belly. Taking a locust pose here again. Hands come back behind you. Lengthen the spine. Let the tailbone and the top of the head reach away from each other. You've got this like penguin sliding. And then lower down. Little variation here. Hands come underneath your shoulders. Press yourself forward and up to a cobra or an up dog. And this time, let your eyes lead you. Eyeballs go to the right. Nose follows as you look over the right shoulder, back at your feet. Eyes look to the left. Nose follows as you come back to center. And then over to the other side. Eyes lead to the left. Nose follows. Looking over the left shoulder. Eyes look to the right. Nose follows as you come back to center. Press yourself on back to downward facing dog. I'm going to repeat that on the other side. Left leg comes forward this time. Right heel down. Rise up, Virabhadrasana, warrior pose. Hands come behind your back, clasping. Opening up the chest. You also have the option to hold onto your elbows. Think about your left hip and hinge at it as you bow forward in your humble warrior. Arms can rise up towards the ceiling. Notice where your focus goes. Pressing the left heel into the ground, feel the connection to your hip. Rise up, tailbones dropping down. Releasing any clasp behind you and choosing to take a lazy hug or eagle arms. Left elbow underneath the right this time. And tipping your pelvis forward. Bowing forward, devoted warrior. Notice your focus. Notice your breath. Notice anything else that comes up for you. Feel the connection from your feet to your glutes, rising up. Releasing the arms back to Virabhadrasana, and then hands come down to the ground. Step yourself back to your plank, pausing in plank, taking a moment to look around. Maybe you make a figure eight with your head. Maybe your eyes follow. Slowly lower all the way down to the ground. Taking your locust pose here, fingertips are reaching back, top of the head reaching forward. Every movement creating a little more length in the body, legs can hover off the ground. Lowering back down. Taking your pathway to down dog, if you want to go cobra, if you want to go up dog, or take anything that we did earlier, you're welcome to. Once you are in down dog, again, a moment for any movement that you want or need, and a moment to breathe. Letting the feet go towards your hands in your forward fold. Eyes lead the way as you lengthen the spine in your half lift. And eyes lead the way as you hinge back down. Bending the knees, let your head take that figure eight as you come up to your chair pose. And then stand yourself on up. Take a moment to check in with your body, little inventory. Continuing with the kind of theme of the day, riffing off of our Hatha sun salutation. So standing at the top of your mat, arms rise up overhead, arcing back. Focus can lift, then hinge at your hips and dive forward. Notice how this feels different than our figure eight that we've been taking. Lengthen the spine. Notice where you choose to initiate from. As you hinge forward, right foot steps back. Take a moment here let the right hip release. Think about lengthening the spine away from your tailbone. And let the focus be on the hip and creating space in the spine. If it helps to go hands on to find that support in that space, go for it. If your hands are off of the ground, letting the hands find the ground, step yourself back to your mountain pose. Feet are together. And then knees come down to the ground. Chest and chin lowers. Pelvis gets left behind. Shift forward and up to your cobra. And then lower right back down. Left forearm is on the ground, parallel to your front edge of your mat. Let the left forearm press into the ground and create length and lift in the top half of your spine. So you've got the support happening. Bending your right knee, right hand finds the right ankle. Breathe and steady. Releasing the right ankle, shift to the other side. Right forearm presses into the ground. Create the support in the upper body before you involve the lower body. You can feel the lats engage. You can feel your tricep engage. Get a nice triangle of support on the right side. Top of the head's reaching forward and up. Then you bend your left knee and perhaps find your left ankle. Releasing that. Hands stacked, forehead rest down, bend your knees. And sway the legs side to side, releasing out the low back. Let's set that up on the other side again. Left forearm pressing down, support underneath the body, front of the body, bend the right knee, right hand maybe finds your right ankle. Kick the right ankle into your right hand and let the left arm release forward. So this is a bow variation. Retrace your steps. Left arm sneaks back in for support, releasing the right foot. Try the other side. Build it up again. Right forearm pressing into the ground. You've got the support on the front body, lats, tricep. Left hand finds the left ankle. Kick the left ankle into your left hand. And then release the right arm forward. Lengthening, going two directions at once, kind of feels like a dancer pose that you fell on your belly. Right arm comes back underneath, find that support. Then release the left ankle. Forehead can come down, bend the knees, release the low back. Make your way to your mountain pose. Any movement that you want or need here. Right foot steps forward, opening out the left hip. Left knee can come down. And again, focus is on the hip here and releasing that out. Hands can rest on the body. Let, again, the focus is on the hip. So spine stays relatively neutral in the lumbar. Hands can come on to support that space. If hands are hovering off the ground, they come back down to the ground, stepping forward into your forward fold. Lengthening the spine and then hinging deeper. Option to reverse swan dive or to take your figure eight back up to stand. Arms come up overhead, palms can meet, taking an arc. Palms come through heart center and down by our sides. All right, taking a variation of our moon salutation. So standing at the top of your mat, let's take our hands behind our low back. Let the palms press into the sacrum, top of the pelvis, fingertips are down, thumbs are out to the side. And let the palms press into the sacrum, top of the head reaches for the ceiling, lengthen your spine. And keep the pelvis pressing forward as you start to arc back. Opening up the front of the body. And then pelvis presses into your hand, hinge at your hips, fold yourself forward. Hands can come down the backs of the legs to your forward fold. Left leg goes back, back knee comes down. Hands can find the low back once again. Pressing into your sacrum, lift the top of the head towards the ceiling and begin to arc back. As an option, right hand can rest on the right knee. Left hand can work down the back of your left leg and be supportive, continuing the arc back. If you'd like, right arm could reach back behind you as an extension of the spine. As another option, left hand can be off of the left leg and also reach back. Wherever you are, slowly retrace your steps. Left hand might come back, right hand might come back. Hands can find the low back again, and then hands find the ground. Stepping back to your mountain pose. Knees find the ground, chest and chin lowers down, resting on your belly. So this time setting ourselves up for a full bow. We did our half bows previously, so feel free to take those once again if you want on either side. If you choose to take a full bow, think about the length of the spine. Bending one knee at a time, hand can find your ankle. And then repeat on the other side. Inner thighs are active, knees are working towards each other. And then you can begin to kick your ankles into your hands and lengthen the spine. Notice where your focus goes. As you breathe, you might be rocking a little bit. And slowly retrace your steps, releasing out the low back. And then make your way back to mountain pose, however you choose to get there. Left leg comes forward, right knee comes down to the ground. Focus on the right hip opening first, and then hands can come to your low back. Palms press into the sacrum, lift out of the hips, top of the head reaching long. You can begin to arc back. And then maybe the left hand finds your left knee. Maybe the right hand finds the back of your right leg. Option for the left arm to reach back behind you as an extension of your spine. Also an option for the right arm to join it. Ardha Chandrasana, or half moon from our Hatha yoga lineage. Slowly retrace your steps. Right hand might come back to the leg. Left hand might come back to your left leg. Both hands might come back to the low back. Shifting forward, hands find the ground. Right leg comes in our forward fold. Big inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up. Fingertips meet overhead. Fingertips dive down through the midline of the body. Chin drops, spinal roll down all the way, rounding the spine. Returning to our forward fold. Heel toe your feet a little wider. You can hold onto your elbows, you can sway. Whatever would feel nice here. Taking a big bend in the knees. Let both shins come down to the ground, slight adjustment. So you can sit on your heels here. So, thinking about circular pathways, really indirect pathways, I'm gonna show forward and then I'll turn to the side. So, hands are sweeping across the body in a diagonal. You can stack the shoulders one direction and then the other, all right? So really big sweeps here, going multi-planar, go sideways, all right? And I've got whatever hand isn't off the ground is there to support me. I'm really reaching out from our center. Your eyes can follow your fingertips, and maybe your nose also follows it. Or maybe there's a slight juxtaposition happening in the skull. If you'd like, you could take this into another heart opener, if your body's up for it, where you choose to lift the hips off the ground as you do this, coming into a half camel, and then back down. So pathway stays the same, all that changes, glutes engage, opening up the hips and the front of the body. And you might choose to round a bit more as you come forward, whatever feels best for you. Taking this one or two more times. And then finding a seat that is comfortable for you. Legs might come out in front. They might be crossed. They might be extended. Now from that multi-planar movement, in segmenting it out. So taking your tilt side to side. Now really just getting into the side body. And again, you can choose to have that support of your free arm underneath. Let your sits bones continue to root down as your fingertips reach away. And from our tilts, we'll take it into a twist. All right. With your twist, notice where your head goes. Notice where your eyes go. Maybe your eyes go a little further than your nose. You can go both directions. You can choose to switch between the two. You can choose to hang out in one. You can have the hands connected to the ground, to your body. When you're ready, when you've completed one or two more on either side, taking an arc and a rounding, a seated cat-cow, opening up the front body and opening up the back body. Now we've done a lot of front body openers, so you might find that it feels really nice to focus more on the back body, which can still be considered a heart opener, just opening a different part of the heart. Practicing our patience and surrender as we start to quiet down our practice today. When you're ready, knees are bent, feet are on the ground. Let's round our spine all the way down to the ground. Taking a moment here, noticing the support and the information coming in from the back body. And taking a bridge pose here. So kind of like our bow, we've got this activation in our inner thighs so that the knees are sending themselves right out over the middle of the toes, right out from our hip sockets. Arms can rest by your sides, either down by the hips or out in a T. Pressing the feet into the ground, tailbone lifts off the ground, glutes are engaging as you lift the hips up. If you'd like to add a little more movement here, you're welcome to let the hips lower down and then rise up again. And maybe the arms join you, like a little wave. Next time the pelvis and the sacrum come back down to the ground, let them stay there. And from here, lift the pelvis up just enough so that your hands can be underneath it. Palms down, and your sacrum, back of the pelvis, is going to rest on the backs of your hands. Now, depending on the length of your arms, the length of your torso, you might choose to have the arms extended, and they might actually be more underneath where your hamstrings will be, okay? So we're working towards our fish pose. So our arms are slightly underneath the pelvis. Maybe it's backs of the hands, again, depending on the length of the body, the torso, the arms. And you'll press your forearms into the ground so that your chest lifts off the ground. And continue to lift, arcing the spine until you can gently lift the torso all the way off and the top of your head can rest on the ground. And extending one leg out at a time into your fish pose. The elbows, forearms, palms pressing into the ground for support. And your head's gently resting. When you're ready to come out of this, find that pressure of the forearms, elbows, palms, releasing the top of the head and slowly lowering back down. Arms can release from underneath the body. Take a moment here with the legs extended, internally and externally rotate the legs at your hips. So it's like the big toes are trying to touch the ground at the midline of the body, and then pinky toes are trying to touch the ground on the outside of the body. Take a moment, a little body scan, a little inventory. What else do you need? What else do you want to complete your practice today? Anything else that would feel good? Anything else that feels necessary? Or perhaps you feel quite comfortable where you are right now. In the next 30 seconds or so, sinking in to your final shape of the day, which might be resting on your back. You might find after all of the opening of the front body, it would feel nice to rest on the front body so you could rest on your belly. You could also choose to rest on your sides or anything else, any other shape that would feel like an appropriate finish for you. For the next few moments, give yourself permission to rest here. starting to bring some movement back into your body. Wiggling around, shifting around, stretching out. Slowly, with as little effort as possible, make your way to a comfortable seated position. Head can be the last thing to arrive. The eyes can be open or closed. Placing one hand on heart center, one hand on your belly. Notice the breath underneath the palms. Coming back to the thought of the day, practice patience and surrender. Ending with a collective breath, inhale through the nose, and long exhale through the nose.